million-dollar question I hear all the time. Is collagen actually good for me? Or is it just a bunch of hype? In this video, we're covering the different types of collagen, because there's not just one, and how each type of collagen scientifically has been proven to help support joint health. Let's dive in. First and foremost, if you haven't already seen my video explaining the joint itself, please check that video out for a more comprehensive overview of the different parts that make our joint function properly. The reason I suggest watching that video is because there are bones, there are cushiony substances such as cartilage, there's a lot of different components that collagen can actually help with. Now you may all be wondering, what does she mean by types of collagen? I thought I'd just get one. No, actually, there are quite a few, and before we start into today's video, I'm going to briefly explain the naming convention so that way you don't feel lost with the amount of collagens. You may see on some of the packaging, contains three types of collagens, or you may see Roman numerals smacked on the label. 1, 2, 3, 5, 10. Clearly, the people that named collagen did not watch the count on Sesame Street.
Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
No, not quite. It's based on the order in which the collagen was discovered. So collagens of type 1, 2, and 3 were all discovered chronologically, but then it made it all the way up to collagen 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. However, the ones in between, such as 6, 7, 8, and 9, were all identified later on to basically be a variant of an original type of collagen. So in essence, the most common collagens you'll find are actually 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 10. And just know these are specifically the ones that are utilized for supplements. So now the big question, what type of collagen is right for me? Well, that's where we're going to dive into the research that supports the different types of collagens and their beneficial effects on different parts of our bodies. In another video, I will go over a taste test and also an analysis of the different brands that exist out there. But in this video, I'm giving you a comprehensive overview of the types of collagen. Starting with type 1 collagen. Type 1 collagen is abundant in the body and really helps with our skin, our hair, and our nails. Upon ingestion, it's broken down into tiny particles called amino acids, which are the building blocks of protein. These amino acids are then used to build new collagen fibers. This process does help in maintaining the strength and durability of tendons and ligaments, thus stabilizing the joints. However, there is some literature that recently has found beneficial impact of type 1 collagen on bone regeneration. So while it's known to really be helpful for our skin elasticity, our nails, and our hair growth, it can have other beneficial impacts. I'll attach the research article to the description of this video that specifically highlight the role of marine collagen, which is fish collagen, and also a type of type 1 collagen, and its beneficial role on bone regeneration. Now on to type 2 collagen. Type 2 collagen is the backbone for cartilage in our joints. Again, if you have not yet seen my joint video, please go ahead and check that out for a comprehensive overview of the different parts of the joint. When type 2 collagen is ingested, it stimulates the production of new cartilage, which therefore aids in the repair and maintenance of joint tissue. There is research that supports this type 2 collagen's impact on the improvement of symptoms for patients with osteoarthritis. I'll include that link to the citation in the descriptions. Now let's move on to type 3 collagen. Type 3 collagen is found in the skin and the cartilage, and it aids in the elasticity and firmness of tissues. Upon ingestion, it supports the structure and function of blood vessels and may aid in the maintenance of joint cartilage. For further reading, I'll attach a research link in the description of this video that supports the clinical effectiveness of type 3 collagen. All right, let's go ahead and move on to type 4 collagen. Unlike the other three collagens I just discussed, type 4 is not as common for dietary supplements. This collagen has a very unique structural role, specifically for our cells, and is primarily found in extracellular basement membranes. Type 4 collagen is extremely important in processes such as cell adhesion, which is where cells can stick to each other, migration of the cells or movement of cells, survival of cells, expansion or growth of cells, and differentiation of cells, which is basically where a specific cell suddenly has a unique purpose, like differentiating between a red blood cell and a white blood cell, just as an example. Type 4 collagen, therefore, is crucial for the integrity of blood vessels and organs. However, as stated, it is not commonly utilized as a dietary supplement unless you're okay with eating human placenta. So hopefully, with the specificity of type 4 collagen, you're starting to understand the diverse functionality of collagen in the human body, but also noticing that there's a lot of crossover between the different types. Now let's move on to our last two, type 5 and type 10. Type 5 and 10, though less discussed in literature, play critical roles in our body's structure and function. Type 5 collagen is involved in the formation of cells and hair. After ingestion, it supports the integrity of cell surfaces and is integral in the formation of collagen fibers, thus playing a role in the overall integrity and functionality of tissue, including those around joints. Type 10 collagen, on the other hand, is primarily associated with bone health. It's crucial for endochondral ossification, which is the process where cartilage is turned into bone during fetal development as well as the growth of children. For adults, type 10 collagen aids in the maintenance and repair of existing bone tissue. And yes, bone is a tissue because it is also made of tiny cells, just like every other organ in the body. Type 10 collagen's role in bone formation and remodeling is essential for joint stability and function, as healthy bones are, of course, critical for healthy joint mobility. I'll also include an article by Shoulders and Reins in 2009 that provides a context for both type 5 and type 10 collagens. So all in all, type 5 and type 10 collagen contributes significantly to the health and stability of our joints and our overall skeletal system. So now you understand that each collagen type does play a specific role in the body, but that it also seems that some collagens have crossover. And when it comes down to it, they all tend to work together in a sense. So understanding this connection and understanding your own body's deficits will ultimately help you make the right decision as to what type or types of collagens you should opt to purchase. So my final note on this, just to take into consideration, is that if you're purchasing a collagen that only has types 1 to 3, that may be beneficial for your joints. But it could be even more beneficial if you included types 5 and 10. And I'll leave you with one more final statement about collagen that I'll cover in greater detail in my other videos, diving deep into specific brands and taste testing collagens. And that is, collagen protein will not build your muscle. You need food-based protein, not collagen protein, to build your muscle. Collagen is for joints, hair, skin, nails, everything covered in this video. So I hope that helps clarify that collagen supplementation is not a myth. It does have scientific literature to back it, but it's critical to know what types of collagen you should get for yourself. If I don't already have them, I will have more videos going through the specific sources of collagen, including if vegan collagen is actually a thing or if it's bogus. Check that out and my taste tests in future videos to come if I don't already have them there. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and always remember, your health is an investment, not an expense.